I get them to sign papers, and they take a few pictures. So we got to enjoy every appetizer, and they'll be there shortly.
Okay, thank you very much.
And the car sweep you off of your feet. With your mouth still remember the taste of my love. Will your eyes still smile from the cheek? Darling, I will be loving you till we're 17. Baby, my heart could still fall as hard at 23.
May their relationship continue to grow in the years to come. Whatever changes time may bring, let this wedding ceremony remain as a treasured memory and a guide to life. May they always experience that breathless wonder that says, out of this entire world, you have chosen me. When life is done and the sun is setting, may they be found then, as now, still hand in hand, still thankful for each other. Amen. Marriage is not a give and take relationship. It is a give and give relationship. If both people give wholeheartedly to each other and to the spirit of their marriage, there is never a reason to take, because all of your needs have already been met. This seems to be a truth that the two of you have already found. I had the pleasure of sitting down with the two of you on a couple of occasions, actually, to talk about your wedding, to make plans for today. A few attributes stood out to me when we were together. There was a kindness, a peacefulness, and a tone of admiration for each other in your voices, and a sense of humor. You definitely have a sense of humor. When one spoke, the other listened. When I asked a question or shared a thought, neither of you dominated the conversation. Then I wanted to hear your story. What path led you to today? Tasha, a friend of yours, Shannon, was a bartender at a local Irish pub. Is Shannon here?
Yes.
Where are you, Shannon? Shannon was a bartender at a local Irish pub where Chad went from time to time. Now, Shannon thought the two of them would make a great couple, but neither of them were very keen on a blind date. So Shannon got creative. She invited Tasha out for a drink. Unaware, she also texted Chad and asked him to join them. He showed up, and you were both pretty impressed with each other. You had your first date the next day, right down the street at the Point Defiant Zoo. Tasha said she knew right away Chad was that person, and even told her friend Stephanie that she was going to be, that he was going to be her boyfriend. Shannon, they wanted me to say thank you. I asked Tasha and Chad to each write down 5 reasons why they wanted to marry the other. They were asked to send their list to me separately and not share them. I asked this for a couple of reasons. It gives them time to reflect on what's important to them as individuals. But more importantly, we don't take time to share with our mates how we feel about them and what's important to us in our relationship. Tasha said, I love Chad because he is kind. He is always putting the needs of others before his own. He would do almost anything to help his friends and family. Chad said, I love her because every time she smiles, it makes me so happy. She has the best smile. Natasha said, he is thoughtful. He really pays attention to the small things and lets me know that he is always thinking about me. Chad said, I love Tasha because even though I kicked her out of the car on our first date, she still wanted to see me again. She even told her friends that I was going to be her boyfriend. I didn't hear that part of the story, so I was. Natasha said, he claims to hate our pets, but I catch him snuggling with them often. Chad said, I love Tasha because she can be as silly as me. She doesn't think I'm completely weird when I be my silly self. Natasha said, he does not always understand my crazy tendency, but he never judges me, and he always supports me. Chad said, whenever I'm in a bad mood or down, she wants to be there to help me get out of my funk. Natasha said, I love Chad because he helps me make the bed, but he knows well enough to walk away when it's time to fold the corners on the flat sheets. Chad said, she is always willing to try new things with me, even if they are a little uncomfortable and out of her element, as long as it doesn't involve heights or too much raw fish. Now, if anyone here has an opinion on why these two should not be married, we simply don't care to hear it. I'm going to ask you to join hands. I want you to look at each other. I want you to see the love in the eyes that are looking back at you. This is the person who offers you strength when you need it. This is the person who will quietly listen when you need to share a thought or to vent a frustration. This is the person who will dial your number just to say hello when you've been missed throughout the day. This is the person who will wipe the tears from your eyes, whether they be tears of sorrow or tears of joy. And this is the person who at the end of the day will be waiting for you and only you. Now before this moment, we've been many things to one another. Acquaintance, friend, companion, even teacher, for I'm sure you've learned much from the other. Now you shall say a few words that will take you across the threshold of life, and things will never quite be the same between you. For after these vows, you will say to the world, this is my husband, this is my wife. Chad, please repeat after me. I, Chad, take you, Natasha, to be my wife. And my one true love. I will cherish our friendship.
help cherish our friendship.
I will trust and honor you.
I will trust and honor you.
I will love you always.
I will love you always.
As I give you my hand to hold.
As I give you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
I choose you as the person.
I choose you as the person.
With whom I will spend my life.
With whom I will spend my life.
Natasha, please repeat after me. I, Natasha, take you, Chad, to be my husband.
I, Natasha, take you, Chad, to be my husband.
And my one true love.
And my one true love.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will cherish our friendship.
I will trust and honor you.
I will trust and honor you.
I will love you always.
I will love you always.
As I give you my hand to hold.
As I give you my hand to hold.
So I give you my life to keep.
So I give you my life to keep.
I choose you as the person.
I choose you as the person.
With whom I will spend my life.
With whom I will spend my life.
Your wedding rings are an outward and visible sign of an inward and invisible bond that unites the two of you. We all tend to fidget with our rings. We put them on our fingers. We twist them. We turn. When you find yourself doing that, let it bring you back to today, the day that you became husband and wife. May I have Natasha's ring, please? Chad, as you place it on Natasha's finger, please repeat after me. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As I place it on your finger.
As I place it on your finger.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I ask you to wear this ring.
I ask you to wear this ring.
As a reminder of the vows.
As a reminder of the vows.
We have spoken on this day.
We have spoken on this day.
Have Chad's ring. I give you this ring.
I give you this ring.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As a symbol of my love and faithfulness.
As I place it on your finger.
As I place it on your finger.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I commit my heart and soul to you.
I ask you to wear this ring as a reminder.
I ask you to wear this ring as a reminder.
Of the vows we have spoken.
Of the vows we have spoken.
On this, our wedding day.
On this, our wedding day.
Did I get on there?
Yeah.
All right. Today, you are making a lasting commitment to share the rest of your lives together, joining your two families into one. You've also chosen to perform the sand ceremony to represent your coming together. I'm going to step aside as you two step forward. I'm going to ask you first to each separately pour a layer of sand into the vase, representing yourselves as individuals. Now I would like you to pour them simultaneously. Blending the sand as your bond is also inseparable. I would ask that you both remember to treat yourself and each other with respect. And remind yourself often of what brought you together today. Give the highest priority to the tenderness, gentleness, and kindness that your marriage deserves. When frustration and difficulty assail your marriage, as they do in every relationship, focus on what still seems to be right between the two of you, not the part that seems wrong at the time. This way, when clouds of trouble hide the sun in your lives, and you lose sight of it for just a moment, you can remember that the sun is still there. And if each of you will take responsibility for the quality of your life together, it will be marked by abundance. I trust most of you here have seen the movie When Harry Met Sally. In the movie, Billy Crystal says this: when you realize you want to spend the rest of your life with somebody, you want the rest of your life to start as soon as possible. Tasha, Chad, your as soon as possible starts right now. Because you've committed yourselves to each other in marriage by the power vested in me by the state of Washington, I now pronounce you husband and wife. Introducing for the first time, Mr. and Mrs. Chad Alvarez. And now you may kiss your beautiful bride.
Thank you. congratulations on a beautiful wedding. I hope that you focus on all the things that went right and not the things that went wrong and enjoy all the champagne in the world.
Tasha, you're like my third sister, so I'm really happy for you, and it was an awesome ceremony, so.
Hi guys, congratulations. It's not Vegas, but this still works. It's a beautiful day and wish you all the happiness in the world. Congratulations.
Congratulations, yeah, I don't know about the Vegas thing. Well, Leah and I almost drove there this afternoon, but we'll tell you that story some other time. Congrats.
Congratulations, Tasha and Chad. May you have many good years together.
Aw, Tasha, you know I love you. Chad, I love you for loving Tasha. Many, many, many good years, and stay out of Vegas.
Congratulations, Chad and Tasha. Here's to years and years and years of happiness.
I am Steve, Angie's husband. I haven't met you yet, but congratulations, and many years of happiness to you guys.
Hi, Chad and Natasha. Natasha, I met you for the first time today, but I am so grateful you invited me to your special day, and congratulations, Chad. I'm glad you finally found the woman of your dreams. So happy for you.
Good job, Chad. All right, so I know we didn't have the best first meeting, Chad, but I'm very glad that the Hunter and my experience and that birthday didn't keep you from letting Tasha invite us to the wedding. It was great. We appreciate being invited. We love you. Thank you, and congratulations.
I'd just like to say congratulations, Tasha, and welcome, Chad. We needed another cousin.
Congratulations, Chad and Tasha. I wish you a long life of happiness.
So congratulations, Chad and Tasha. From now on, you will be known as Chad Tasha.
Hey, cuz, and Chad. Well, I guess you're a new cousin, too. Okay, yeah.
Chad
Tasha. Congratulations, and I hope you guys have a great marriage in the rest of your life. So.
Congrats.
Yeah.
Your great Uncle Morris, and I want to say this to Chad. Remember, if you want to stay married for 68 years, like my wife and I have, remember to keep saying, yes, dear, whatever you want, dear, anything you want, dear. Thank you.
Tasha, I was just remembering what happened when your parents brought you home from the hospital. And I can remember you were just such a little teeny tiny baby. And when your mom would take you up the stairs, your dad would walk right behind you in case she dropped you. It was the cutest thing I ever saw. So I just want to say congratulations, Tasha, and have an excellent marriage. It was a beautiful wedding.
Tasha, this is Kristen Bill, and we're wishing you many, many years of wedded bliss.
Hi, Tasha. Hi, Chad. I want to say best wishes for all the rest of your married life, starting today. Just be good to each other, be kind to each other. Don't go to bed mad. Always talk to each other. And that's the best advice I can give you. Bye-bye.
Congratulations, Tasha and Chad. Chad, welcome to the family.
Congratulations. Congrats. So happy for you.
Very excited for you guys.
Can you do something? Chad and Tasha, congratulations. Wish you many long, happy years and good times.
Congratulations.
Hi, Tosh, Chad, congratulations. Everything is beautiful tonight. And don't go to bed mad. I love you both.
Tasha, you've come a long way from the camping days and with me having to help you go to the bathroom and cover the toilet seat for you. I think Chad's a great guy, and I wish you both happiness for many years. Congratulations. Bye.
Hey, it's your little brother. I'm extremely happy for you, and I'm glad I made it out. Love you, buddy.
Welcome, everybody, to the family. Chad, we're glad to have you. Watch out for Tasha. Don't let her get too many bees in her bonnet.
Okay, Chad, I know you don't care much for my music, but to quote one of my song lyrics, never throw away a happy memory. Love, Dad.
Tasha, Chad, I love you both very much, and all I can say is, you're welcome. I introduced you, this is why we're here, and I knew it. Happy many, many, many years, and lots of kids. Love you both.
Chad, Tasha, congratulations. I'm glad it's finally over. We should have done this like 6 months ago, but it's been wonderful anyway. So good luck and carry on.
I just want to let Tasha and Chad know that you guys are one of the coolest couples I've ever known. You guys are soulmates and will be together forever. And I love you both so much.
Mine's shorter and sweeter. We love you. You're my favorite couple. Hope to see you a lot more.
A lot more.
A lot more.
No more wedding planning. Mwah.
Volume and game. This is always saving me. I was going to do a big, long speech, about 30 minutes, but I thought, no, she won't like that. She won't like that a lot, so I'm limited by my 5 minutes here. Thanks. It's dedicated to Natasha, and it's kind of a poetic form with a little bit of prose thrown in, which means I can't rhyme everything, okay? I'll try to speak up. I hope you all can hear it. You're my daughter. Tasha, today's your wedding day. I knew this day would come. Today's your wedding day. And I'm only your father. I know I should have seen this coming. Dads, though, are protective of their daughters, so we are seldom really ready for this moment. Your wedding day. I have to add the sum of all the memories I have collected over time. Your first night home, a nursery rhyme. Today's your wedding day. I'm as proud can be to see you happy and full of joy. Chad and you give us all a smile. May your love grow mile after mile. You had curiosity. You were our bright light. Before 9 months, your first steps came in talking to a pink blanket you chose to hug. We went with you everywhere, snug. Today's your wedding day. I remember the times you spent in play. You'd come home from school and play school all through the night. You loved the water just as much. Water skiing with just a tight. You'd rather swim than ride a bike. Grade 4 came along. Mr. Lorenzo was your god, the Penguin King. Mr. Poppins lit your fire. You and Heather, day after day, what memorable times we did admire. Oh, and to perform on stage was your desire. You would sing songs day and night. Food, glorious food, what a sight. And Annie, oh Annie, it's a hard not life for us. And be my little bumblebee, buzz around, buzz around. You were a busy little bee, all right. Sometimes even a hornet. Oh my Tasha, today's your wedding day. Should I shed a tear or smile? Only a while ago I gave you away. Chad. Listen now. Did you know her name, Natasha, is Russian, and it means Christmas Day or birthday, referring to the birth of Jesus. I read War and Peace and was so inclined to name her after a character I loved in that epic piece of Russian literature, Natasha Rostova. She was mysterious like you, Tasha, and shy, yet so bold. And smart, I see that in you too, always. A springtime flower about to unfold. My Tasha, a phrase I love to say. You could see the day coming when you would go on your way. Sometimes I wish time would slow down, and then you'd catch me in a frown. Summers passed too quickly. Teachers spoke so highly of you, of the talents and gifts you had. Mathematics to you came easy indeed, solving problems when only three. You were always amazing, always taking the lead. In college, calculus and statistics too. I wish I could help you more, but you were already on your way, sailing with growing confidence. You left your old man behind. Today is your wedding day. But more memories still come to mind. While still a young lady, you and your best friend, Heather, would find times to meet boredom, sometimes at your poor brother's expense. Like when you two convinced him of how much fun it would be for him if you two clever minds could trap him in a box and shove him down a flight and a half of stairs. You lost your halos that day. Of course, you and Heather were always together. Do you remember? Two goofballs calling the police and chasing our house painters who we thought were trying to break into our home. Then there was the day we, the two dads, Joe and I, we took our sweet young girls to the Rainiers game. What a mistake. And returned home with an entire high school baseball team drooling over both of you. That was scary indeed, for the dads that is. Today's your wedding day, Tasha. Can you remember the boarding adventures along the way? Blue Lake, Banks Lake, and the Sea Ray. Week-long camping and giant dust storms.
Oh.
Trips to the beaches and sandcastle forms, cruising to the Caribbean on Destiny and Triumph at sea. You swam at the giant rays and then fear jumped on me. We watched you grow up through high school proms and graduation days, a Washington State scholar and times for praise, a Washington Husky at last a degree, and you showed your independence at last, free to just be. Out into the world, go girl, a house in your plan, you go girl, I think you found the man. Dad has to stay, today's your special day. I have to admit it, when your mother and I first met him, we spoke with one voice, our daughter's in love. We made a great choice. Today's your wedding day. Chad is the one, a man from Nevada. He captured your heart and asked for your hand. You both fell in love. Now today, here you stand. Your wedding vows done, a joyful future's begun. Today was your wedding day, my Tasha. My bright light, Natasha, my dear. You and your Chad, we now stand and cheer. And now, let us now celebrate the marriage of Chad and Tasha with a toast. Would you all lift your glasses? We all come together, two families and friends, to honor your love. May it be filled with compassion. May it be a fountain of goodness. May God bless your lives together. And may it be eternal. Thank you.
Nervous or anxious here. You're either me or you just married Chad Albers. Yeah, so I looked it up online how to make the best man speech. And the first thing they tell you is prepare something. So I did. And I'm glad I did because what I have to say is just from my heart. I was there tonight, Chad and Tasha met, and it's been a journey for me too because Chad's been my buddy. I mean, we're bros. We ride, we dive, we do everything together. And the first night he met Tasha, we were having fun shooting pool, and then this confounded woman kept wanting to share our pool table. And then, I realized she's pretty cool. She's all right. And then the next day, I realized that was it for Chad. He was in love. One night, he's in love. And that was it. And so it was really fun to watch because Jan made reference to when he kicked her out of the car. And Tasha was wise enough to realize that he's not exactly Rico Suave. Because he was in love. And I'm happy for both of you guys. I really am. Couldn't have made a better choice. So it's been fun for me, and I wish the magic continues. So please, everybody, another one. Tasha and my Chad. And by the way, I didn't lose a bro. I gained a pain in the ass sister.
huge, huge honor. And I'm only slightly terrified right now. When Tasha first told me she wanted me to give a toast today, I naturally assumed that she was trying to get back at me for something. But anyways, I'm grateful. We first met about 10 years ago. Belinda introduced us. And I only got to meet her one time. And I thought, wow, she is serious. And she's super smart, really responsible and practical. I think she was already talking about buying her first house. And it wasn't until about 5 years later that we got to meet each other again. And I realized she's all that, and she's also wickedly funny. She's so funny, in fact, that I often refer to her as my most quotable friend. Never mind. So I think having gotten to know Chad and watched their relationship grow, it was that funny, witty Tasha that first drew him in. But it was the practical Tasha, the one with a purpose and a vision for her life and where she wanted it to go, that made him understand that he wanted to spend the rest of his life with her. And they will be together forever, I know. Mostly because she came home right after came to my house right after the first date and told me, he's going to be my boyfriend. She knew it right away. But also, I think because of the way that Chad proposed. He put so much thought and care and love into that trip to the lighthouse that day. After Tasha told me the story, I just knew they were going to be together forever. And they will. I know they will. I don't really know what else to say, except I wish you guys much, much joy and lots of chubby babies and grandbabies. And many, many laughs for years to come. To Mr. and Mrs. Alvarez.
You have more siblings? Okay, even, even, okay. Who is older? Okay. Who said, I love you first? Who's the better driver? Who's been in more accidents? Who's the better cook?
Chad!
Chad!
Who's most likely to get the spider out of the bathroom?
Chad!
Who spends more money? Who's most likely to get lost? Who asked for directions? Who talks more?
No.
Oh. Yeah.
Who's the biggest flirt? Who's got the strangest families? Who's the better kisser?
Ha 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 ha!
answer. We'll find out later, right? Okay, and today, Adam Moore, anybody else in the world, who do you love more than anybody else in the world? All right, thank you for doing this, you game. Ladies, on a count of three, we're going to be having the flowers coming your way. On a count of three.
Don't think you're ready to catch.
You're ready. Here we go. Count of three. One, two, three.
Single gentlemen
to the dance floor, please. Single gentlemen. Once again, all the single gentlemen to the dance floor.
Now you can get married.
Okay, last call for the single gentlemen. Last call, single gentlemen. Carter coming your way on a count of three. Hands out of your pockets, guys. Here we go. Count of three. One, two, three. Thank you for that dancing for the first time as a married couple, Mr. and Mrs. Everett.
Smile, knew my heart was stolen. just goes down a little bit.
Oh, that's the video.
Yeah.
Oh, it is a video.
Smoking room, smell wine and cheese.